Welcome back to another Coffee with Dr. A. Today we're going to talk about why 0% unemployment rate is actually a bad sign for the economy and is an undesirable target. As an educator and a person that works in policy, people often talk about how unemployment rates are high and how we should get it as low as possible. And deep down in that conversation, there's this assumption that we should be shooting for a 0% unemployment rate. It's never explicitly said, but I know it's in the background. And today I want to tell you why 0% unemployment is actually undesirable and signals an unhealthy economy. To do that, we need to talk about what unemployment is, first of all, and then the different types of unemployment. To be considered unemployed, actually, you have to have been seeking a job in the past 4 weeks. You also cannot be a student, a retiree, or institutionalized. Unemployed individuals are people without a job that are seeking a job. And that's something that a lot of people don't really get. They believe that if you don't have a job, then by definition, you are unemployed. And that's a misconception. It's not understanding the economic term of unemployment. Also, to better understand why we don't want a 0% unemployment rate, we have to talk about the types of unemployment. There are three types of unemployment: frictional unemployment, structural unemployment, and cyclical unemployment. Each one of them happens for different reasons, and each one has different economic policies that help mitigate those unemployment issues. Let's talk about frictional unemployment. What frictional unemployment is unemployment that arises when people have the skills, they are looking for a job, and the job exists out there. It's somewhere out there. However, the job seeker and the job cannot find each other, or it might take a long period of time for them to find each other. And that's what we call friction in economics. So the job seeker is looking for the job's out there. Sometimes there's government policies that impact the search process. Sometimes it's just transaction costs. How do you look for a job? What is the process that you take to find a job? Where are you searching? These all go into frictional unemployment. A great example of this, and a lot of people could relate to it, is once you graduate from high school or college and you start looking for a job, you are initially frictionally unemployed. In this case, the role of the government or any entity that is trying to minimize the amount of frictional unemployment is to make it easier for the job seeker and the job to match. The other type of unemployment is structural unemployment. And structural unemployment is this idea that economies evolve. There's a lot of innovation that's happening in an economy, and when innovation happens, old jobs become obsolete. And when old jobs become obsolete, those individuals have skill sets, but those skills are no longer applicable in today's economy. So due to the structural change of the economy, they have become unemployed. Another example of structural unemployment is an outside factor. For example, COVID-19. COVID-19 has changed the structure of how we do things. In higher education, an industry that I am part of, it's changed the way we operate. And actually, this is an example of an innovation that has occurred due to COVID-19. It's an innovation for me, because before COVID-19, I was not creating videos. I thought what I did best was teach people in person. And now I'm trying to learn how to teach people online. And this is the experiment. And the YouTube channel has grown out of that experiment. And that's how people evolve. If you do not evolve, you become structurally unemployed. And the role of the government or any entity that is trying to mitigate structural unemployment is to allow innovation to happen, but minimize the structural unemployment by providing training and upskilling opportunities. And this is where higher education could come in now too. Provide individuals with skills to operate in today's economy. There's also a connection between structural unemployment and frictional unemployment. One thing that could happen is if frictional unemployment takes too long, so if you're unemployed for a long period of time because you're searching for a job, after a while, you become structurally unemployed. Your skills have depreciated and you no longer could operate in today's economy without first receiving additional training. So that's why it's important for us to know and recognize what is frictional unemployment and what is structural unemployment. The final type of unemployment is cyclical unemployment. Cyclical unemployment is the unemployment that arises due to the ups and downs of the economy or the business cycle. Recessions and expansions change the amount of people that are working. Therefore, if people have become unemployed because we've gone into a recession, meaning that there is not enough demand and profitability in the economy, and therefore firms have to let go of people, they are cyclically unemployed. And in this case, the role of the government or any entity that is trying to minimize cyclical unemployment is usually through monetary policy and fiscal policy. This brings us to an important concept, and that concept is called the natural rate of unemployment. The natural rate of unemployment is this idea that in every economy, there's going to be a natural amount of unemployment that exists. Because in a healthy economy, we still want people to enter the labor market. In a healthy economy, an economy will innovate. There's going to be structural changes because of economic growth. So eliminating frictional and structural unemployment entirely means that we're eliminating new people coming into the labor market and eliminating innovation. But eliminating frictional and structural unemployment will imply that our economy is not growing and we're not bringing new people into the economy. And that's why we don't want a 0% unemployment rate. So while you're at it, like, subscribe, leave a comment, and tell me what you're thinking.